Congratulations, you're alive. That's a big deal. It means that every one of your ancestors successfully avoided death, at least for a while. It also means that you come from a very long line of people who are good at being scared. Lend me your ears. Today we offer a tale of sound, science, and fear. Welcome to the Sci-Fright Zone. In my video with What's That Buzz, we saw how easy it was to take something that's not normally that scary and add a little bit of fear using a few sound tricks. Now, fans of scary movies know there's primarily two ways that movies use sound to scare you. The old jump out from behind a corner trick, or using sound to set a more generally frightful mood. Now, sound is nothing but vibrations. What is it about our biology that makes only some of them scary? Now, when I say scary, I'm not talking about that creepy kind of scary that grabs you slowly with its cold, ethereal hands. That slow fear only happens when your higher brain functions take over. The kind of fear I'm talking about is instant fear, the fear that's built into your very biology. So why do we get scared in the first place? Well, simple, so you can live long enough to reproduce. If you want to avoid being a lion's dinner, you've got to think fast. Luckily, sound moves faster than sight. Now, light waves move about a million times faster than sound waves, but a lot of your brain gets in the way first. Think about what it takes to see something. First, light has to activate several kinds of photoreceptor cells in your retina. Then a signal travels down your optic nerve, where it stops in the center of your brain and gets sorted. Then it goes back here to your visual cortex to be decoded with the edges and the shapes. And then it goes off elsewhere in your brain so you can finally remember that the shape you're looking at is a lion. Whew. All in all, that process could take up to half a second. Now, I don't know about you, but when I'm staring down a hungry lion, that's half a second too long. This is why we say we live in the past. Like the train station in hell, when it comes to what we see, we are forever delayed. Now, whether it's optical illusions or even just paying attention, it's the very complexity of our visual system that makes it so easy to fool. But hearing operates on a completely different wavelength. I love puns. While you can shut off your vision pretty easily, your sense of hearing is never really off, even when you're asleep. And you're just not conscious of everything that you're hearing, which is good because otherwise you would go completely nuts. In his book, The Universal Sense, Seth Horwitz explains that hearing is a mechanical rather than chemical sense. To demonstrate, let's say I sneak up behind you. Between your inner ear and your muscles tensing, that signal only has to travel through 5 nerves. The whole process is over before the rest of your brain is even aware what happened. You can't fight it. This is hardwired into your brain's anatomy. This so-called startle reflex is probably the fastest thought that you can have. Of course, startling us isn't the only way that sound can make us feel things beyond our conscious control. Here's a famous example. Now, we have no idea what a T-Rex actually sounded like, but for Jurassic Park, they blended the sound of a baby elephant, a growling tiger, and an alligator's low-pitched snarl. Using animal sounds to invoke terror is one of the oldest tricks in the movie book. Jeez, that's enough. A 2010 study by researcher Daniel Bloomstein analyzed scary film soundtracks and found that they contain more of what's called non-linear sounds, which contain things like rapid frequency jumps or non-standard harmonies, noise, or when an instrument or a voice is pushed beyond its normal range. Animal alarm and danger calls seem to be full of these non-linear sounds. It seems to trigger some sort of innate danger signal inside of our brains. Now, they've even incorporated these non-linear sounds into film music, which I can't play for you because of intellectual property law. But I put a bunch of links down below, so make sure to check these out. In Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds, Oscar Sala made non-linear bird noises using an instrument called a trautonium, and Stanley Kubrick's The Shining owes its super creepy non-linear soundtrack to the Polish composer Krzysztof Penderecki. And in The Day the Earth Stood Still, Bernard Herrmann used what is probably the most non-linear instrument of all time, the theremin. The list goes on and on. Nobody knows if these composers consciously added nonlinear sounds to their music, but the effect on the audience is unmistakable. Our brains evolved to be scared by that. We've seen how movies use sound to scare us to death, but our brains are really scaring us to life. So go enjoy that scary movie. Just remember that even if you close your eyes, you can't escape the Sci-Frite Zone. Head on over to What's That Buzz to watch our super scary cat video. And if you'd like to watch something a little less frightening, then subscribe to this channel. Stay curious.